like the style. I like the look. It looks aggressive. I don't know, for me, this is just my opinion. Though I get a lot of compliment here. It's hard for me to park, that's the other thing. Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. So we're gonna wash the Chevy Colorado, our truck today. It's my mother-in-law. So as you all know, Travis is not here. I use this truck for almost a month now, and she needs a good bath today. But before that, I'm gonna tell you guys what using this like every day, what I don't like and what I like about using this truck. But I'm gonna show you later on. Before that, let me get the key. All right, first of all, we got the key here, and what I love about it, because we have the remote start. If you live in a, you know, like a cold, wherever, like in Michigan, like it's always snow, it's good to have a remote start, you know. So we'll start the truck first. All right, look at that. And I will show you guys. So every day I always struggle. Sometimes I struggle here, and my height is 5'3". But if your wife's driving your truck and your truck has a lift, because my husband put a lift, I don't know how many inch, I think 2 inch, I'm not sure. So here, we're gonna start the truck. This is kind of different because you have to push the gas and then press this button right here. So for me, it's different. I don't know if in other vehicle it's the same like that. I don't know, because you know, I haven't really drive in my entire life. This is my first time driving here. I learned just last year. And what I noticed is, if you start the car, the auto stop is on automatically. And then when I ask my husband, can you turn it off or set it where every time you start the car, it's not on all the time. But he said, I don't know if you can. So every time you start the car, you have to push the button if you don't want the auto stop. I don't know if it's a good thing. So auto stop is off now. And sometimes I don't like it if the auto stop is on, because sometimes, you know, I forget. And then every time I stop in the stoplight and then you hit the gas again, it will start the car, like fresh start, you know. So yeah. And but the other thing is, there's no handle here, which might be good if both passenger and driver's seat have, you know, have the handle. But if you put steps right here, should be fine. But you know, it's not really that bad. And here they put the handle, and also this is kind of like the cheap seat cover that my husband bought, just to protect the seat, because we have a dog, Great Pyrenees dog. And yeah, what I love about it as well is, you have a bigger truck and you can use it for like moving some stuff. You buy some furniture or whatever in some store, like you bought the couch and you can put it in the bed of the truck. Yeah, so. And the other good thing here is, I like the style, I like the look. It looks aggressive. I don't know, for me, this is just my opinion, but for me, I like the look of the Chevy Colorado. I also like the ZR2, but I told my husband he's not gonna get ZR2. He's not gonna switch to ZR2. I love the Chevy Colorado. I get a lot of compliment here. And they were so shocked when they knew that I drove this car. Because every time I go to work, and then when they knew that, "Is that your truck?" I told them, "No, that's my husband's truck. You're driving that?" Because they said, "You're tiny and you're driving the big truck." Because it is big and it's hard for me to. I drove the CR-V and it's smaller, way smaller than this truck. And what the good thing is, you have some cameras here that will help you a lot. And I will show you all the camera that will really help you guys. And if your wife will drive this, it might be difficult in the first time that they use the truck, but you don't want to rely on this camera. This will just additional help. So yeah, you will see it right here, and you have other, like when you, yep, that's the front camera. See, you even have the top camera, your wheels. Yep. It's a cheating, I know. And my mom. I know it's a cheating, but it helps a lot. But for me, as a first-time driver, I still have to look around. I don't have to. I don't want to rely on this camera, but it's still good, you know, to check and to check and use that sometimes. Not really dirty. Yep. See. So we still have this knob side pad lights here. I think this is one of the best pad light that they have. And yep. It's not too bad. Yeah, it's really dirty inside. Oh yeah. Yep. Sometimes I'm doing off-road in that area. And my husband don't know about it. All right, so we're gonna start washing the truck, and we will use this. He always loved to use this Adams brand, Adams polishes, so we're gonna use that. All right, let's go. Thank you. It's looking nice and clean now. Look at that. Yep. Shining. So all in all, I love the Chevy Colorado, 2023 Chevy Colorado. I love to drive it, and it sits higher, and I think it looks cool, especially the front. I like the front look of it. It looks aggressive, and what do you call that? It did really good in the trail, and we maybe next month we will go to the trail again in the mountains, and we will do another off-roading. Abangan you guys. Maybe June when he gets back here, and we will plan to go to the trail again with our friends. And yeah, so all in all, we love the Chevy, and look at that. As you can see, I like the Chevy Colorado, and it's not really that hard to drive it at first. It kind of make it like difficult for me the first time, because it's bigger and wider than the CR-V, and it's hard for me to park it. I really struggled the first time that I drove it, so but now I get used to it and I love it. So that's all for today. Thank you guys for watching. See you again next time. Bye.